You might recall that in late December, OpenAI announced their latest, most capable AI model, O3, and they gave us some record-breaking benchmark numbers along with that release. Now, you probably heard all about that already, so I won't bore you. But of course, you might be aware that there was some criticism regarding some of these benchmarks and how the model may have achieved its great performance. But even if you do take that criticism into account, obviously O3 is a very capable model. It's also a very expensive model, though. When OpenAI announced it, when they shared all the details about those benchmarks and so on, it also became clear that O3 was super slow and expensive to run. Like, extremely expensive, spending hundreds of thousands of dollars or even millions of dollars to solve the tasks they wanted it to solve. So, not something you and I will probably be using for complex tasks anytime soon, though we can see what it really is capable of doing when we're able to use it a little bit later this year, as it seems. However, given the fact that it is so expensive to use this model, and given the fact that we probably need even more powerful and capable models in the future, and that training and developing such models is also super expensive, or is it? I'll get back to that. But given that this is all extremely expensive, it makes total sense that Project Stargate was announced. Now, what is Project Stargate? Well, as announced by OpenAI, it is a new company which intends to invest $500 billion over the next 4 years. And it's not just OpenAI that's in that project. Instead, it is actually like a joint venture, you could say, of SoftBank, OpenAI, Oracle, and MGX. SoftBank will have the financial responsibility, OpenAI the operational responsibility. And ARM, Microsoft, NVIDIA, Oracle, and OpenAI are the key initial technology partners. So lots of NVIDIA chips in there. It's also worth noting that this project, to me, by all the sources and data I was able to find about it, is not publicly funded. Those $500 billion seem to come from these companies. However, it's clearly incentivized by the US government, by Trump in the end. Because they also make it very clear in that announcement that the infrastructure they're going to build will secure American leadership in AI, clearly something the Trump administration or any US administration would be interested in, and that it will create hundreds of thousands of American jobs. And they're going to start building stuff, so data centers and probably nuclear power plants and things like that in Texas. So they're throwing a lot of money at this AI problem in order to build and run even more capable AI models. And I'll also get back to the question how this will impact your or my job. However, throwing money at this problem makes a lot of sense, right? Because it is all super expensive. At least this was true until a couple of days ago, when DeepSeek, a Chinese AI company, released DeepSeek R1. And that is an AI model that's essentially on par with OpenAI's O1 model, so not the O3 one, but its currently most capable model, O1, and even slightly better than that O1 model in some benchmarks. So that's interesting. A Chinese company catching up, definitely good for them, you would say, and kind of proves the point that it makes sense for the US to invest heavily into AI to like pull ahead again. However, what's interesting is that this DeepSeek R1 model is massively, like really massively cheaper than OpenAI's O1 model or other comparable models like the one from X and so on. It's up to 96% cheaper to use DeepSeek R1 than it is to use OpenAI's O1 model through their API. In addition, what makes DeepSeek R1 even more interesting is the fact that it's an open source model. So unlike OpenAI, which has nothing open about it, this model is truly open source. And that's good news, I would say, for most people outside of OpenAI and Microsoft, because it's good to have competition there. It's good to have choices and not to be essentially locked in into the leading AI company, OpenAI, or maybe two or three leading companies. It's great to have competition there, and it's great to see that the Llama models by Meta are no longer amongst the only very capable open source AI models. So that is good news. Now, of course, it should also be mentioned that DeepSeek R1 comes with its own problems, like, for example, censorship. If you ask it critical questions the Chinese government probably wouldn't like, you're not going to get answers or meaningful answers. But of course, kind of the same thing, I guess, could be said about OpenAI's models, where there also is a certain bias or a certain trend that can be seen in answers to certain questions. So we'll have to see whether we get a truly open source large language model anytime soon. Nonetheless, it is interesting to see all that development in the AI space. Models getting more capable and cheaper, kind of at the same time. That is exciting, especially now that we see more and more competition in that area. Of course, though, it can also be frightening, because what does this mean for all our jobs? If these models get better and better, it seems like it's only a matter of a few years at most until we're all out of our jobs. And of course, obviously, no one can look into the future, but I'm pretty certain there is no reason to be too concerned here. For one, you can of course take a look back into human history and you'll see lots of technological breakthroughs, which in the end always turned out to increase our productivity and create new and mostly better jobs. So that's one thing. But also in addition, all this change never happened overnight, even though it sometimes might have seemed like it does. And certainly it does seem like that now. But change takes time. So we're not talking about a few years here. And finally, it's yet to be seen whether these AI models, and especially the future AI models, will solve all these problems the current generation of AI models definitely still has. It's yet to be seen if they can truly become replacements for humans. I'm extremely doubtful about that, because being a human is more than just being able to reason. And even when it comes to reasoning, there's lots of complexity in that process that's currently not replicated by those models. So I think we're safe now and also in the near future. Instead of being too afraid about all these developments and new models, I would really recommend to embrace them, use them as helpful tools, look into business ideas and opportunities that might open up due to these models being available. See if you can reap some benefits there, if you can take advantage of these models. If you're a developer, which you probably are if you're following my channel, take advantage of these models to become more productive. Set yourself apart from all the other developers. Go deep into development, expand your knowledge. knowledge, learn the advanced stuff to bridge that knowledge gap that will open up as more people are able to build basic stuff with all these AI models, whilst not being able to build the more complex things. That is where you can set yourself apart. And what I would recommend that you do if you are into development and if you are concerned by all these developments. But of course, please also let me know your thoughts, your comments below the video. Super interested in hearing about that, and see you in future videos and episodes.